What's going on, everybody, and welcome to the Full Game Walkthrough Series, episode 167. Welcome to Chrysalis. You can see by the bug atmosphere. we have to get the UFOs team completely spaced. So we're going to hurry up and get these real quick, and then we'll start our journey in Chrysalis. I always, by tradition, talk to Zeke. Before we do that, though, I got to give a quick overview over my gear. 94 damage, 41 resist, 17 accuracy, crit and block. It's a little low for the block end. You know, still trying to get that robe. Struggle beyond belief, let me tell you. Power pip is up, healing in is up, and so yeah, I am using the Boots of the Unknown Tartarus. We do have those. Well, the robe gives crit, but you know what I mean. The Trixie Hood, probably better than the hat. It's all up to discretion. Let's talk to Zeke team. The UFOs.
Hey there, little wizard. Whatever brings you to Azteca? Looks like I can't get away from you.
What a champion.
I come to Azteca searching for a pack of critters called the UFOs. I never seen one, but I want to believe in them.
Yeah?
The Aztecans say they're skittish and that they scattered all across these parts, but they might be pulling old Zeke's leg. Can you see if you can find them for me? I don't need you to do anything with them. Just tell me where I can find these UFOs. They sure are funny looking, too. Whew. Some folks say they look kind of like swamp gas. I'll let you be the judge of that.
Alrighty. So, I know where the majority of them are. When I say majority, I think like four or five. Boo Boo has been destroyed, team. Thank you again for everybody who stopped by on the stream. Here's the first one right up here, team. The Zocalo. Well, it's kind of like a secret area. It tries to be in a secret area, really close to where Zeke actually is. The next one's in the 3 points. My goal is to get level 100 before we leave part one of Chrysalis. Here's the UFO in the, cenote. So be prepared. I'm excited, don't get me wrong, but I'm very worried as well. I mean, who wouldn't be, right? Let's go to the marsh. Let's go back to the Zocalo. But the frame drops are real with Boo Boo being crashed. It's almost... It is pretty hilarious. All right, this UFO is by the giant gem area that we had to go in Mangrove Marsh. Let's go to the swamp. I'm telling you, it'll get you. We gotta be careful over here. So remember this pyramid? Well, the UFO is right here. Literally right there. All right. Alright, let's look at where other ones we have to do. The Dock, Cloudburst Forest, Tierra Debris, Alto Alto, Floating Mountains, Twin Giants. Okay, I know where the one in Alto Alto is for sure. Floating Mountains, I know where that one is. Let's just go in that general area. Let's go back to the Zocalo. I'm not getting salty, I promise. I'm not getting salty. It's wood chest. Alright, let's go to... Where's to next? Tierra Debris. Yeah, I'm gonna cut to when we get to this. So, I'm gonna go get the rest of them. I'll see you all when I get there. Wish me luck. The UFO and the Floating Mountains team is on the Isla Tormenta. The next one we're gonna go for is in the Tierra Debris. I'll see you all when we get there. Tierra Debris UFO by the Emerald People. Next one we're gonna go for, team, is in the Zoltan Dock. I know where that one is now, and then the Twin Giants one will see you all then. Alrighty, team, the UFO in the Zoltan Dock. Literally behind a house. little bit salty there. Last one, team, Twin Giants. I'll see you then. Alrighty, team, the last UFO on the Twin Giants is up here, past the volcano door, behind a singed hut. Let's go back to Zeke and start our not really start our journey in Chrysalis, because you'll know what I mean when we when we get there. Let me tell you, it gets ya. and I'm trying to remember all of it, but I'm really excited too. I'm spooked. Zeke, what do we got?
You did it! Woo! You probably best not tell anyone that you saw those UFOs. No one's likely to believe you.
Whoa. We have 1,000. Team. Legendary Explorer. Azteca Explorer. You gotta love those titles. Alrighty, well. Can't really port back to home. I still have that crafting quest. I think I promised to do that when I was in Celestia. We're just gonna do it whenever we do it, team, at this point. I just wish I could abandon it. I don't even know why that's not in game. Just abandon a quest? I mean, I don't know. Because I do all my crafting on my death. Let's go talk to Meryl. Start our journey, team. And also equip a new mount that I have. We're gonna have several mounts in Chrysalis. Part one, I thought we'd start things off a little bit spicy, team, with something you normally don't see too often. At least I don't. You can buy it in the Crown Shop. There's a lot of varieties. I thought I'd start out something with, a butterfly, huh, team? Why not? Look at this beast. Legitimately a bug-em good. Let's talk to Meryl and start our journey, shall we? The final world in the walkthrough. So far. Well, it will be continued. Anyway, Meryl!
Ah, my dear young wizard. You are well rested, I hope, from your last ordeal. It is long past time we dealt with Morganth. We must rally the forces of light. Sadly, the council is reduced to only Diego, the Emperor of Mushu, Lydia Greyrose, and myself. I need your aid, for you have forged a robust relationship with many defenders of light. Travel to Savaria and convince the mystic in younger white stripes to join the Council of Light. Then go to Avalon and find King Artorius in the Knight's Hall. Tell him his might is needed once again. While you carry these messages, I will send Diego to ruined Azteca to call upon Princess Zenzen Sevenstar. Deliver your messages, and then return here at once.
Team, this is where we get King Art spell, so my memory recalls. But yeah, this is a butterfly. I was gonna get a dragonfly, but I thought, you know what? Let's have the butterfly have a time to shine. I think it's a little bit spicy. But the official mog for the walk, well, for right now, this is what it is. Which world are we going to? Oh, the Zafaria. All right, let's go talk to Inyanga. Yeah, I think there's a lot of prelude stuff. A lot of it. Inyanga, what do we got?
Jambu, young wizard.
Jambu!
It has been some time. Even from here, I can see that the shadows grow long across the spiral. You wish my help? Of course. I will do what I can to aid one who did so much for my world. What is it that I can do? To join the Council of Light? You bestow a great honor upon me, wizard. Tell Merlambros I will come to his side at once.
Alrighty. Talk to King Art. We are literally 1,000 XP from leveling. I don't think it's been that close. I mean, literally, how much? Yeah, that's like 1,010. Pico de Gallo, long time no see. Time to talk to King Art. Friar Nolan, pleasure as always. We're moving. Oh gosh. It's kind of funny though. It's like, never mind. Let's go talk to King Art. just a lot of thoughts in my mind right now, team. Hello, King Art.
By the spiral, it is the young wizard back amongst us. But I can tell from your visage that dark times are still ahead.
Okay.
Merle Ambrose asks me to join the Council of Light. That I cannot do, for there is still much work I must do to restore the land. But Avalon will not refuse Ravenwood in this hour of need. Instead, the Lady of the Lake will go in my place.
Where's she at? Am I not seeing her? Where's she at?
Speak to her and tell her it is my command. But before you go, I have one more gift for you, blessed Knight of the Silver Rose. The Sword of Kings has bonded to your spirit. You may summon its power whenever you feel the darkness press upon you. Use it only for justice.
Oh, and there it is, team. The King Art spell. We now have it. Hype beyond belief. 50 damage and then 1,000 some per. And then, yeah. So, let's go talk to Lady of the Lake. Rally the forces. We're moving. This sounds a little bit low today, my bad. Especially for this amazing music in Avalon. You gotta love it. I'm trying to remember how to get to Lakeshore. It's been a while, team. It's been a while. I'm trying to think. No, this isn't it, is it? No. Where do I have to go? Is it here? No. That's not Dundara. Which one's this guy? Catacombs? Yeah, was it? Okay. I think the catacombs, but then you go through... Okay, I know where I'm at. I had to remember, team. I apologize. I mean... I've been in Azteca way too long. Did not mean to go through this door. I did not mean to go through this door. I know that. That was not intended. I promise. Alright, we're going. Bum ba bum ba bum. There we are, Lady of the Lake. But that's not the Lady of the Lake that we need to talk to. Oh gosh. Oh yeah, over here. Wait, what? Oh yeah. Over here. Well, I guess this is the quickest way. To my knowledge. I see, that's the thing. Who knows? I mean, it doesn't really matter, but... Alright, Lady of the Lake. Talk to me.
By the spiral, wizard, you stand at the center of the dark storm, with nightmares all around you. You bear word from King Artorias? Of course I will join the Council of Light and help you in the battle against the Great Shadow.
Alrighty, let's go talk to Meryl, team. Gathered all these forces. We gotta talk to Hilda the Brew as well. We need some potions. What a struggle. We're moving. Oh my word, team. So yeah, we have 4,000 health. Our damage and our resist is, I believe, really good going into KR. But the world itself is still really, really intense. For those who have never been, it is definitely an eye-opener. Meryl.
That was quick. You flew with the speed of Gamma's wings. What did they say? I'm pleased to hear Inyanga White Stripes will join us. Excellent work. And what of Avalon? It saddens me that Artorias will not fight at my side again. But the lady is a remarkable spirit and will serve us well.
We've leveled up.
Preparations. Morganth has retreated to the Shadow Web at the center of the world of Chrysalis. Chrysalis is a strange and alien world on the farthest bend of the spiral. It was a place of savage wars and ancient magic. The spiral key we once had was destroyed long ago, so we must forge one anew. A tiny isle broken from the edge of Chrysalis is still reachable, however. Professor Lydia Greyrose will get us there. Visit the School of Ice and use Professor Greyrose's ice archway to journey to the Isle of Arachnis, so we may craft a new key.
Amazing. I think these guys are jumping up and saying hi. How are you? On my way to... I can spell this right, team. There we are. Amazing. Take care. They're Promethean. They're in their noob gear. But hey, sometimes you just gotta cleanse. Thank you, Tarlac. Adios. It's nice seeing ya. We're moving, team. I may seem a little bit uneasy today. I'm spooked, but I'm really excited. Don't get me wrong. I mean, we're okay. I mean, I'm really excited. I'm getting goosebumps. Oh yeah, we gotta talk to Grey Rose. Praise Grey Rose. We have a another snow day today. Grey Rose.
Young wizard.
That's
I've
a little
been
bit close.
For you.
That's a little
I built
bit
an
much.
Ice archway to take you to the Isle of Arachnis.
This is I'd have to say phase two of, like, phase four of the prelude stuff, team.
The ice archway is across the way in the ice tower. Pass through it and find Headmaster Ambrose. He's waiting for us there.
Yes. Yes. Yes, I am. All right. Well, we're starting our journey, team. In uncharted territory. Definitely an area not to mess with. And yeah, this looks a little bit different, doesn't it? Yeah, well, it is. I think the ice tower is... I don't think it's permanently like this way. Well, welcome to an island. Isle of, you know, or whatever. It's Arachna? Yeah. I believe, if you can see off in the distance, that is Chrysalis, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, it is. I can see the part one, the tower. Yep, I see all of that good stuff. Let's talk to Meryl. Got Diego, Emperor Yoshito, Zenzen, and Yanga, Lady of the Lake, and Lydia Grey Rose, Meryl himself, the Council of Light.
Ah, young wizard, what kept you? Welcome to the Isle of Arachnis.
Thank you.
Arachnis is a fragment of the spiral world of Chrysalis, broken off hundreds of years ago by Morganth in her recklessness.
You can see Chrysalis there, through the storm. A savage world. A dead world. It gives birth to terrors and draws nightmares like the candle pulls the moth.
Morganth is learning the song of creation from the Lords of Night. It requires all her focus, but she will learn it. When she masters it, she will brush us aside like motes of dust, and the spiral will be hers.
Morganth has shielded Chrysalis.
That Zumo team!
Key, there is no easy way to get there.
So we must make a new spiral key.
Has such a thing been done before?
Not in a very long time. Emperor?
These zooms are on point today, team. Emperor, what do we got?
To create a new spiral key, we need elements to embody Chrysalis herself. The triad of life, death, and myth must be served. The Condor Woods were a wondrous forest, teeming with life and blooming with possibility, until Morganth burnt it
down. The Condor Desert, Condor Woods team?
Now it is a lifeless desert, brimming with bitterness and anger. Still, where there is hope, life and light can take root. The last seed of the last Condor tree is nearby, guarded by wordless woodsmen. These tree folk are all that is left of the once great forest. Bring the Condor seed to us.
34,000 XP, team. Rank 12 elites. Okay, so that's not that bad. Let's remove... I have to change this up, because I was farming Tartarus, and I was helping Blade and Faint and whatnot. So let's fix up the deck real quick. With the recent edition of the King Art spell, I will not be using it on bosses, but for PvP, one of the best team rivals Medusa with the Ninja Pigs and all of that get them good stuff. So look forward to that. Let's put in some Humongo Frogs. Let's put in, I think that's good for that. Let's put in three of those. Two of those. We don't need that many, do we? Well, I guess we do. Enchants, what am I doing? We need those as well. Alrighty, for that. Reliquary for that. And then the Faints, just in case things get I can say fancy. I almost said Francy, I guess. Put these in. Where are my McMuffin blades? There those are. Alright, let's defeat these cats. Oh, so we are above 4,000 health now. I didn't even realize that. Alright, let's defeat these people. I'm a little bit worried, but then, well, 4,000 health. We've seen worse. We have definitely seen worse. Let's faint. We're not having it today, are we? I know, I'm not. Bum, bum, bum. I remember when I think the reason why I struggled with this area is because, let's be honest, my death wasn't that good. I think there might be some lag issues. I know Crystals has a few of them that are particularly bad, from if my memory serves me right. I don't want to worry about those, but I don't think they happen until part two of Chrysalis, especially in the beginning-ish, and then in certain parts. So, different times of Chrysalis. It's a very long world, for those who know, two parts, moons, let me tell you. But a lot of story, you learn a lot of things, and that's why I love the world. Some people don't love the world. Well, for obvious reasons, of course, right? Struggle and whatnot. But being it is the final world of the second arc. Fantastic. And I'm so happy I'm finally here, in all honesty. It's gonna be so sad, but that's the thing, though. The walk with the myth will not end here. It will be the finale in this world. But it won't be the finale, because the new world, with our three starts, we're gonna start that journey with the myth again. Yeah. Let's put on Reliquary just in case. I know we have 94 damage now, which I believe is a 5-6 damage increase from the other gear. So we'll have to see how that goes. 41 resist as well. But I think our block is okay. We're most likely going to be crit on. But, you know, once again, I'm relying on Midnight's heals. Hopefully she is awoken from her sleep in Azteca. I sure hope so. No crit here. I think it's just going to have to determine for how much damage we have. I think I'll do 4,000 or 5,000, I hope, at least. Alright, so now I know. Three blades with that. Whatnot. 6,000. Not bad at all. No, honestly, not bad at all.
When scattered, you recover a hard seed about the size of a plum.
The size of a plum, huh? Alright. Emperor Yoshishido. What a treat seeing all these people, though, huh?
Poor, tortured creatures. Perhaps we will be able to help them one day.
But today is not that day. We must work quickly, yes?
Yes.
You are correct.
Whoa!
Good work, wizard. You got the Conda seed.
It's kind of cool, though, because, like, we didn't know about the Conda Desert till part two. And this is part one, right? Because it came out in different times of the year. Or, like, you know, two different times.
This will act as a conduit for life magic and be one of our anchors for the ritual.
So it's kind of, you know, nice seeing that connection.
Now we turn from the spark of life to the black void of death.
Wow!
To build the triad, we must take the last Conda seed and fuse it with a symbol of closure and endings. The Lady of the Lake will guide you here.
Lady of the Lake, hello, how are you?
The strongest magic is sympathetic. We draw on the life and death and myth of a world to recreate what was lost. Morganth trails death and destruction in her wake, so much that it clings to her like bitter smoke. The spiral still weeps for Azteca. An undead Aztecasaur dwells here on the Isle of Arachnis. This grinning Kalaka is a lost remnant of the First World. His bones resonate with Azteca's requiem.
See, let's be honest, Lady of the Lake. Kind of wanted to leave Azteca.
Battle Grinning Kalaka and get the Underworld Compass, a relic of death magic. Bring it to Queen Zenzen Sevenstar.
Alrighty, so he's a boss, huh? Well, he thinks he's a boss. Alrighty, let's go down here. How are you expected to get that Mistwood? Can I ask that question, team? How is one expected to get that Mistwood? I don't even think that's worth it. If that was a fossil, would you try and go for that? Yeah, I would, but I think it's impossible. All right, what's down here? Oh, he's just ranked 12. Oh. Alrighty, that's interesting. Wait, doesn't he like... I feel like something fishy happens. Nope, nothing fishy, never mind. I thought something did. Alright, we went first. This music's going in! Yo! It's the start of the spooks! Not too bad. Arm fell off, as usual. Nothing different there. Right, remove that, remove that. Remove one of those, we don't need double. Well, spirit blade it up. Hopefully find sharpened next. That would be great. Bum, 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 bum. But yes, I will be crafting ninja pigs when the time comes. I'm not going to be farming for it. Because Wu knows that I do not get drops when I farm, especially for spells, so, I apologize for that, you know, just like the luck of randomness, no, not gonna happen this time around. We'll hit after put on this plus 45 blade, very important. So, yeah, I think it's 60,000, I was gonna say $60,000, no, it's 60, it's, 60,000 gold and or 70,000, and then I don't think it's that bad to craft, which I think it's still pretty bad to craft. I think I need a lot of amber, which I think I have, so we'll have to see how that goes in time, because I've been getting some questions about that, so. But my goal today, just kind of just like bringing things back
from
here,
out of the bones and ash,
is to actually finish this prelude stuff.
Carved with death school symbols around an Azteca sun.
Alrighty. Level 92, the first piece of gear, team. 92. Zen, what do we got?
Wizard, this underworld compass thrums with the cries of my people. It also keens for the brave souls of Chrysalis who have fallen under Morgant's reign. It will serve our purpose. Show it to the Lady of the Lake.
Lady of the Lake, hello.
Wizard. We now possess 2 points of the triad we need for our ritual. A combination of 3 schools of magic is nigh unbeatable. We have life and death. The 3rd point is formed by myth. Inyanga White Stripes will show you how to bring them all together.
All right, Inyanga.
The triad of life, death, and myth is the foundation for our greatest stories, yes? The professors from Wizard City have brought a powerful relic with them, the Diamond Myth Forge.
Cyrus was not through to lug it out of the basement of the myth school, but he would not refuse me.
Bring the compass and the underworld compass to the Diamond Myth Forge. We
will
channel our power to you. You must perform the ritual of forging and hammer the elements into a spiral key.
Alrighty. We'll use the myth forge. Cyrus, he's just like, oh, that Grey Rose, she's getting... I can just see him. He's just like, I'm gonna get you, I'm gonna slap you. But it's just like Cyrus's antsy attitude. It's funny.
Excellent work, young wizard. This. I can feel you channeling our power to your ritual.
Remember to temper life with death, death with myth, and myth with life.
Do not lose control of the triad of magic.
Picture Chrysalis in your mind's eye. Feel its essence in the ground beneath your feet and in the heart of the Conda seed.
I think the combining of things is a little bit over there.
Listen for the echo of all those hearts that Morgant has stilled. The underworld compass points you to her black place of power.
Excuse me?
Oh my. Let us see what you have.
Oh my. Done.
A new spiral key. Wonderful work. And with this, know that we consider you an honorary member of the Council of Light.
I just got chills, team.
Young wizard, Morgant's wards keep us out of Chrysalis, but we will remain here as close as we can get to watch over you. We may even be able to project ourselves into the world in astral form, and give you what guidance we can. Morganth is forcing the ancient Astekasaur spirits, the Lords of Night, to sing the song of creation anew. In her version of the great song, she is the stalwart hero, battling the cruel forces of injustice. But if she is able to complete her song of creation, the spiral will be forever broken. Go to Bartleby and use the spiral key to travel to Chrysalis. Morganth's sentinels will think you are there to join her forces. Use whatever trickery you must to find and release the Lords of Night from Morganth's clutches. Then defeat her once and for all.
Yo! Three times the spooks and chills! Alrighty. Goodbye, Isle of... well, the Lost Conda Forest. See, I didn't even... those are the things that you miss, team. Literally flew over my head like, whoa! Yeah. Didn't even notice that. Let's go to the Universal Door. Bartleby still has one eye. Hopefully two eyes in the future. Who knows what Arc 3 will bring, team. Alrighty. Chrysalis, we've made it. Well, we still have some more prelude stuff like Phase 4.
What is your name and purpose?
Zoltana, my friend, the leg. You do not remember me because I'm in a different... well, you know, I'm just... yeah.
Headmaster Ambrose said to use trickery to let them think you were here to join them. Maybe you can avoid a fight if you talk to her.
It's actually so crazy how different the atmosphere is after you completely finish Part 1 and Part 2. You'll know what I mean after we actually do it. Zoltana!
Have you come to serve the Shadow Queen?
Excuse me?
I am Zoltana the Mirror Mask. It is my duty to test those who wish to swear allegiance to Queen Morganth. Prove yourself, stranger. Go into the Weeping Tower and slaughter all you find within.
Alrighty, team. So, next time we will finish all of the prelude stuff to Chrysalis. My goal today was to actually make it to the world. A little bit of the background story getting to the actual world as well. This is the spiral door. It's a little bit sad, I'll be honest. it's destroyed. But we have to go inside of here. Let me just show you real quick. We have to defeat these. I know it's a beyond struggle for Storm, because then you have to defeat some really powerful bosses. This used to be the spiral door, and as you know. So I will see you all next time. We'll finish all this stuff and start our journey in the Moon Cliffs, I believe, and or we have other stuff to do in the actual Bastion area. Take care, team. Leave a like if you've enjoyed. I'm really excited. I'm spooked. I'm anxious, but I'm really excited. It's like all these mixed of emotions. I'll see you all tomorrow. Take care, team.